All right, boys and girls, here's the way it lies. You're going in first, Richard. Dustin, you're going in second. Mina, due to your clarity, you pulled up the caboose. You're number three. All right, guys, to the fruit stand.
Ticko!
How's it going, fella?
All right. Well, these guys is made up good jaw of moonshine, popcorn certain style, but they need a little bit of something to add to it.
All right, we'll see what we can't do. Y'all come on with me. And I tell you what, guys, that's why you never bring your mother-in-law to the still. You know, I mean, just being honest. All right, got all kinds of good stuff in here for y'all to flavor y'all's liquor with. I believe there's a lot of stuff in here that's popcorn approved. Each one of y'all are gonna have 5 minutes. Richard, you are first, and your time starts now.
I'm a firm believer in too many moving parts creates too many problems. I just want to give a simple flavor to these judges because I don't want to overcomplicate the matter.
I'm going to take all
You're going to take all the tomatoes. Are you going to actually make liquor with that?
Yes.
You
yes.
are. You're Some really going to make liquor. Liquor with that. The bell peppers, too?
Some real good
Some
liquor.
Some real peppers. Green beans, them tomatoes, if you had some onions. And them cucumbers, you cut that up over top of your green beans, and that's good eating right there.
I'm good right here.
You're good?
I'm good right here.
Wow, that was quick because you had 4 minutes left, Richard. Take your stuff over there. Dustin, your 5 minutes, it starts now.
I didn't come with a plan on the flavoring. I said I'll wing it when I get there.
There we go. Dustin has a pie.
Might get hungry.
Okay, he might get hungry. At least he's thinking ahead. Damn, you got something to wash it down with, too, didn't you?
Oh, well, I got to get enough for everybody now.
When I seen the apple cider in there and the honey, I felt really comfortable with it.
Got 2 minutes left. Your time is running out.
Is he shopping like he's at a store?
He's strolling down the grocery store out.
Don't forget my pie.
Hey, yeah, be careful with that pie. Are you good?
I'm going to make it work.
All right, good, because you was darn near out of time there, Dustin. Our last one picking today is Mina. And your time starts now. Are you going to have to move faster now?
I was inspired by Whiskey-Liqueur, so when I saw the classic baking spices, I grabbed cloves and nutmeg, allspice. And when I saw the sorghum, I was completely excited. It's something that I've been really wanting to work with.
Well, there's corn right yonder. You can't make good liquor without corn.
I've got to fill with the shuck.
Okay, well, you do have to shuck that corn.
I grabbed cherries and apricots, and I felt like they complemented the spices. It, like, holds it all together.
Are you good? All right, well, Mina, take your stuff over there. Now that we've got all our ingredients, let's get this stuff back to the still site and see what y'all can do with this, all right?
Man, I'm kind of hungry. You bought that pie, man. Right. I'm ready to eat now.
All right, guys, welcome back. Got your baskets full. And when it comes to this flavored liquor, we got the first lady of moonshine right over here who knows more about flavoring than a jackrabbit knows about running, Pam Sutton.
Hey guys, I'm Pam Sutton. I'm Popcorn Sutton's wife. I made my own flavors. I had apple pie, peach, watermelon, grape, and blackberry. Everybody seemed to like them all, so we'll see how y'all do.
You've run your liquor like popcorn. He didn't flavor liquor with anything other than fruit. He put fruit in there because he liked to eat it himself. When it comes to flavored liquor, y'all got your own skills you brought to the game, which ain't nothing to sneeze at.
But you know, some of you here, not to mention no names, Dustin and Mina, gonna have to do some blending to get your proof up there because you know, when you do that flavoring, that's gonna dilute it. Now, Richard, your proof is there, so you may want to just flavor it heavily, but be careful. Sometimes when you're doing these flavoring, you can turn it into medicine.
Guys, you got 1 hour. Build us your best flavored jar. Take your time, use every minute. Your time starts now. Good luck.
All right, y'all ready?
I'm ready. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready for you to heat that pie up.
That's what I was getting ready to do.
There you go.
Well, you know, all of these guys competed before.
Okay.
And they're all master distillers. So all three of these guys bring a lot to the table in flavors.
They do. Okay, Mina, what are you making?
I have a southern liqueur flavoring. So I'm using nutmeg and clove and allspice. I was inspired by Whiskey-Liqueur. It's something that I've been really wanting to work with. I wanted to make something subtle roasted apricots, complemented the spices, and I had the sorghum instead of cane sugar.
Mina, is this something you've done before, or are you shooting from the hip?
I'm shooting from the hip.
Atta girl, I like it when it works under pressure. Guys, you got 5 minutes. Time's drawing nigh to you.
Mina, I thought I saw what was a look of bewilderment on your face just then.
I was reflecting in regret that I didn't grab orange. I feel like this could really use orange, but I guess I'm gonna move forward and deal with what I got.
Do not worry about what you don't have.
That looks pretty over there.
I know, right?
Hope it tastes good, though. These guys in here tell you the truth.
We hurt your feelings.
Even if it hurts your feelings.
Minute and a half, boys and girls.
No.
Hit this a little bit harder.
I changed some stuff last minute on to get a little bit of different flavor, and I put some dark brown sugar. Much better. Hoping to outdo everybody else, but we'll see.
30 seconds, guys.
Jesus.
All right, brother, if that's the one, we'll deliberate a little bit, and we'll come get you. Good luck.
Thank you.
And here comes the hillbilly.
Oh, go right ahead.
Looky here.
Just in case y'all need a little encouragement. Thank y'all.
Good luck,
thank
both of you
guys.
Going to be really.
He finally got it warm.
Ain't no way of telling the beat at this point.
So let's just get to tasting and get this over with.
Well, let's try this one right here.
Dustin,
he's got a few things floating in there. I guess that's for flavor.
Biggest flavor I've seen him put in there is sweet.
I think he's going for apple pie. Oh, and Pam, you get the first shot. I'm smelling honey.
Mm-hmm. I smell honey.
It tastes good.
I feel a little bit of burn, just a little.
Tastes liquor in it, tastes alcohol, it gets you to that point.
He said he was going to make apple pie, and he brought apple pie.
It's about as sweet as I thought it'd be, but there's just enough liquor in there to balance that sweet out.
Apple pies usually are not over 50 proof.
No.
That's a good drink.
That's a real
this
good drink.
This tastes real good.
Richard. Looks like a lava lamp.
He was going to make us something with that tomato.
This is going to be really different.
I'm smelling cucumber.
Well, he got some of that pepper in there.
It's not bad. It's just extremely different.
The only thing it's missing is celery.
Pete had a couple more ingredients and tweaked it just a little bit. He'd have been spot on, wouldn't he, Pam?
A little bit more mater, and I think he'd have really been on point.
I'm like you, Digger, a little more tomato.
But I'm going to say he's still 90-95.
Still high.
It's high.
Yeah, he's still got plenty of liquor in it.
Let's move on.
Mina. Well, she's got a bee laying up there and ain't going away.
Ooh-wee, that's right in the middle, ain't it?
She is a botanical expert.
Botanist.
All right, well, this is going to be the surprise.
It was very obvious she was out of time before she was through.
It's got some kind of root floating in there.
I think she put ginger in it. It smells good.
Now, that's out of the box.
Go easy on that there, Mom. It's got some octane.
And a burn. A little bit of burn.
Yeah. Hoping,
good.
Yeah.
It's got the alcohol.
Look at them legs
sure.
On that thing.
That's good.
She just raised the bar to another level. Mm-hmm.
She understands flavor.
She understands what goes together and what don't go together.
Well, guys, you've heard all the chatter from this side. But without holding anything else up, Pam's going to present the prize to Mina. Great job.
Good job.
Yes, Mina.
Thank you. I'm so honored, Pam. Thank you so much.
You are welcome.
I am a nerd and have a large library of books, so to have that one that has had Popcorn Sutton's hand on it and his spirit in the writings is just an amazing gift.
Don't get no liquor on that book, though.
Place of honor.
And you know what you really need to do? Miss Pam certainly needs to sign it for you.
Yes, I would like everyone to sign.